Ryan Garcia looked phenomenal against Fortuna. Then after the fight, he called out Tank and Teofimo Lopez. What do you think of those two fights for Ryan? Well, and you know that, Ryan, I'm sure.
I think the problem with Tank versus Ryan is, at what weight is he going to come back down to 135? I mean, he seemed like it was even hard for him to make 140. It's just a really big guy. So I wonder if that's going to be the factor that prevents that fight from happening. And then that trends things to Ryan versus Tio because of the higher weight class.
Now, how do you see that fight unfolding? Tio's fighting August 13th. So theoretically, they could make that fight November, December.
You know, I'm not trying to say this as just straight hate, but Garcia still got his chin up in the air. Like, that's going to be a big problem versus a top-tier guy.
23-0, 18 knockouts.
His defense is going to be a big problem versus top-tier guys. His offense is there. His offense is world-class. His defense is why...
He looked great in defense in the last fight. He was blocking. He was moving.
That guy wasn't there to fight.
Yeah, because Ryan took him out. Ryan dropped him three times.
Yeah, he did. The defense is what... It's going to be a hindrance to Ryan Garcia versus the top tier guys.
Well, he's with Joe Goosen.
Yeah.
And
Hall of Fame trainer.
So it sounds like you're favoring Teofimo.
Yes. And not sleep. Those
yeah,
games.
Probably.
Yes. All right. Let's hope. Let's see. I want to see Ryan in big fights. He's ready. I want to see Tank in big fights. I want to see Teofimo in big fights. It's exciting.
And if he can come back down to 135 and fight Tank, that'd be a very exciting match.
One of Tank's coaches, Kenny Ellis, said the other day, he talked to ES News, and he said, Tank, I'll fight him at 160.
Yeah, I don't think that's going to happen.
He said the weight class doesn't matter.
I mean, yeah, I mean, Tank fight fucking at, what's his, Barrios at 140.
Yeah, Barrios is a big dude.
Barrios is a big dude, who also went up and lost at 147, but yeah.
Well, Tank did better than Keith Thurman did against the same opponent. Tank stopped him where Keith Thurman...
He did, but you also don't know, like, what is taken out of you by making weight.
Or by losing the Tank.
Or by losing Tank, sure.
Because you may not be the same.
But boxing is full of these circumstances where guys were at a particular weight class and they go up in weight, and you would think things to be worse for them going up in weight. They actually get better. Which shows you, like Miguel Cotto at 140 was a pretty darn good fighter, but at 147 he was much better. So you could tell that making the 140 was really hurting him.
What happens to you as a strength and conditioning expert?